Hi guys, welcome back. So bookkeeping is something that either you have to learn it yourself or outsource it when you run a business. Hopefully it's possible to learn how to do it yourself and manage your own books. And in this video, I'll share with you exactly how to use QuickBooks Online. So without further ado, let's get into it. QuickBooks is the most popular small business accounting software. You can use it to record your transactions, manage your income and expenses, prepare taxes, and much more. So there are different versions of QuickBooks, and if you go to their website or click in the link in the description, you'll see a few options. If you are based in the US, you'll have 5 options: Simple, Essentials, Plus, Advanced, and a cheaper option for self-employed people. If you are based in Canada, you'll have 6 options: Easy Start, Essentials, Plus for small businesses, Easy Start and Self-Employed for freelancers, and Advanced for mid-sized businesses. I personally use the Plus option because I sell physical products, so I need the inventory, I need the cost of goods sold, and some other features in the Plus version. You should compare these features to see, based on your business, which plan works best for you. So welcome to the QuickBooks Online dashboard. As you can see, at the top of the screen, we have the logo and the company name. We have the main menu on the left side, and on the top right corner, we have Help, Search, Notifications, Setting, and your account. Now, this is your business overview, where you can see your invoices, expenses, profit and loss, bank account, and sales. You can click on My Accountant to enter your accountant email and invite them. If you don't have any accountant, you can click on Find a Pro. But if you can do it yourself, that's absolutely fine. Below the dashboard button, we have the banking button, which is where you link your bank accounts and credit cards to QuickBooks, which is one of the first things you need to do. Linking your bank account enables QuickBooks to download all of your transactions every day and match them to your bills and expenses. Now, the only thing you need to do is to just review and categorize these transactions. It's very quick and simple. Just select the vendor or customer's name, select the category, and click Add. Sometimes you're gonna have some monthly expenses like internet, phone, or rent. And if that's the case, you don't have to categorize these transactions over and over again. You can just go to the rules and create a transaction rule. For example, if your rent is, let's say, $2,000 every month and you use 30% of your home for business purposes as your office, you can create a rule that every month QuickBooks categorizes 30% of that rent as office rent and 70% as personal draw. The next menu is Sales, where you can manage your invoices, customers, and products or services. This is Payroll, where you can manage your employees and contractors and create paychecks. And then we have the Reports tab. This is where you run all of your financial statements, like your profit and loss or your balance sheet. So the profit and loss report is where you monitor your business performance, which gives you a summary of your revenues and expenses over a period of time. On the other hand, the balance sheet shows you a summary of your assets and liabilities over a period of time. The next menu is the Taxes tab, where you can manage your sales tax if you are registered for that. This tab is Mileage, where you can automatically track mileage using the app, so it's easy to calculate your tax savings and make every kilometer count. There is the Accounting tab, where you can find your chart of accounts and bank reconciliation, which is where you reconcile all of your transactions between QuickBooks and your bank accounts. You can do it once a month to keep everything organized. Now, if you're an Amazon seller and you want to enter your Amazon payments, let's say manually or automatically, you can watch these videos over here, where I show you exactly how to download and categorize all of your Amazon payments. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any questions, make sure to comment below. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.